Hi friends, welcome to Prsoft technical channel. In the C language series, today we are going to see the program number 37 and pattern number 4. In the last lecture I explained about different patterns, and today we are going to see some more patterns in for loops. So today we are going to see how to print even numbers in pattern and also how to print odd numbers in the pattern. So today I will explain you these both patterns. So let's start with video guys. I hope guys you have seen my last videos. Please watch all the patterns because all the patterns are very important. So we'll take a new file. Add the two header files guys here, hash include stdio.h, and the second header file we have to add hash include conio.h. We have to add this two header file. Then we will take one main function, and then here we have to add integer I comma j comma n. And I will take one more variable k is equals to 2. Okay, why we are taking this I will tell you in couple of minutes. Then write enter the number and then read the number scanf percentile d comma address of n, and just we'll print the we have read the value, and now I will write the two for loops. One is I is equals to 1, I less than or equals to n, I plus plus. And the second will be for loop j is equals to 1, j less than or equals to n, j plus plus. This is the second for loop we are writing, and just we have to print what? Printf will print the k value here, percentile d comma k, and I will write k is equals to k plus 2. Guys don't worry, I will explain you all the logic in just a minute. And just I will write here this logic. Okay, this is our logic guys. I will explain you with diagrammatic concept. Just see this. Okay, this is our program guys, and here I will mention all the variables. Suppose example, I'm having I, I'm having here j, I'm having here n, and I'm taking k. My k initial value is 2, n I am considering here 3, you can take any value, it's not a problem. And j initially is 1 and I is 1. See, I is equals to 1, I less than or equals to n, nothing but 1 less than or equals to 3. Condition is what? True. It will come inside. J value is what? 1. 1 less than or equals to 3. Condition? True. It will come inside and it will print the value of k. What is the value of k guys? 2. The next statement is k is equals to k plus 2. Nothing but k will be incremented by 2 and the value will become 4. Now, again here it will come here j plus plus guys, it will not come out until this loop become false. So j plus plus is nothing but what? J value will become 2. Now 2 less than or equals to 3, condition true, it will come inside, it will print the k value. K value is what guys? 4. It will print on the screen 4. K is equals to k plus 2, nothing but value will become what? 6. Then j value will become increment, j value will become what? J plus plus become 3. 3 less than or equals to 3, condition true, it will print the k value. K value is what? 6. Now k is equals to k plus 2, nothing but 8. Now j plus plus, j value will become what? 4. 4 less than or equals to 3, condition false. False means it will come out and it will go to new line, cursor will come here. Then again I plus plus, I value will increment by 2 and it will come inside. Whenever it comes inside, j value will become what? Again 1. Again, 1 less than or equals to 3, condition true, it will print the k value. K value is what guys? 8. 8, again k plus 2, nothing but what? 8 plus 2, 10. Again, j plus plus, j value will become 2 and it will print the k value is nothing but 10. So like this it will goes on guys, it will print 12, then 14, 16 and 18. Like this it will print on the screen guys. Okay, so similarly what I explained this first step, it will goes on till third row. So just first we'll compile and we'll check the output guys. Go to execute, compile the program. I will give pt4.c, nothing but pattern4.c, and I will just save the program. Okay, it is compiling. Okay, now we'll run the program and I'm giving value is 3. But see guys, how it is coming? 2, 4, 6, it is all, it is going mixed. But how our input is like this. So we will just here we'll add the, instead of this I will add here 2d percentile 2d I will add. So our output will be the proper way, nothing but two data types it will take here. Run, I will give 3 and just I will enter. Now see how we are getting 8, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, but still we need some space. So what we have to do, just go inside and here you add one space. That's it. Go to compile once again and just go to run. And here I will take the 3 value. Now see, perfectly we got. How is input? Sorry, how is our expected output? The similar way we are getting the output. So like this, we can print the even numbers, guys. If you need the odd number, guys, nothing to do here. Just you have to take here value is 1. For even number, we have took what? 2. For odd number, you take it 1. Rest everything will be same, guys. Nothing to be changed. Just compile once again. Go to run. And just give the 3 value. And now check the output. Expected output is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17. The similar way we are getting. How it is coming? Just I will explain to you guys. See, k value first is printing 1. Then increment by 2. Nothing but 3. Then increment by 2. 2, 5, 7, 9, 11. Like this it is executing. The similar here. But the only difference is instead of the 2, 4, 6. It is in printing 1, 3, 5 and so on, guys. Still if you are having any doubts, guys, you can just send me a mail. I will reply on that. Or just you comment me in the comment box. So I will just solve your problem, guys. If you like my video, guys, please subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you for watching this video, guys.